surfing softball here. Today is September 2nd, 2009. I'm going to make a ribeye bone-in steak and thick fajitas. I'm going to show you what I got at Academy. I got one of these meat hooks for flipping over the steaks or meat from a company called Grill Gear. 99 cents. Got three of them. Anyway, I thought that was a good idea. Anyway, you know, so just gonna probably use salt. What else? Let's see. Salt, pepper, maybe some Greek seasoning, something like that. I don't know. Not sure. But getting some mesquite wood going over there, and we grilled on the Tuscany grill. It's pretty easy. Alright, so we'll go ahead and get started and carry on to the next. Oh, hold on, y'all. I got a call. Hold on, let me answer. Jeff Falls. Look at that. Hello? Hey, man, what's up? Oh, yeah. No, I'm just making ribeyes and fajitas. Yeah? Oh, okay. No, you're gonna put salt on it and a little bit of pepper. Oh man, don't cook it that hot. You're gonna burn it. Alright, well hey dude, I'm kinda busy right now, okay? So, I'll call you back probably, I don't know, a couple weeks or something. Alright man, later, bye. Sorry about that, it's my friend. Anyway, back to the movie. Let's go ahead and get the meat out of here.
We got a fajita that I've hit with the meat hammer, and steak. It's about that thick right there. About that thick. 1 inch thick steak. So right here I got Adams Reserve, San Francisco Bay sea salt, and I'll put some in the cap that the humidity hasn't got to yet. There we go. And simply sprinkle this on, both of them. They're both going to be spiced with the same stuff. Very simple. If you know, before when spices first started, they only used salt, okay? It's been around for thousands of years. So we got salt, and in cheer, we got pepper. Fresh pepper, so. I got this thing, and of course it doesn't work as good as some of the other ones I've had. There it goes. Forgot to tighten the thing on top. There we go. Anyway, we're going to put salt and pepper on them. Let me show you what we got here on that one. So we got salt and pepper. So let me do both of them and we'll grill them up. Okay, I put the coals in. They're smoldering. Smoldering, is that the word? No. They're heating up. Turning red, so it's gonna take another 10 minutes anyway. We've only got 213. I'm infrareding the grate, so that's not even nearly ready. Alright, we're gonna do the steak first. I'm gonna grab the steak with this deal here, just like that, and lay it on, like so. There you go, folks. Pretty easy. Got a nice little hook here. You just shoop, shoop. Flip her over. All right. Let it cook a bit. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and stick it in the same little hole. Grab it and flip it. There we go. I'm searing the juices in like Greg Rempe showed me on one of his tutorials. So that's what we're doing. Okay, grab it, flip it this way. There you go. See what we got. Oh yeah, looking good. All right. fire is getting mighty hot now. Yeah. All right, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take it, put it back here. Still hot back there, but this is hot, hot right there. Then I'm gonna lay this big old fajita right here. Can you see in there? Fajita. We've got a lot of smoke and fire going on. Flip the fajitas over. Look how fast they're cooking. Grilling's the way to go. Grilling is the way to go. Man, it smells good too. Hey, here comes people. No, this is a private party, folks. Maybe on Labor Day we'll have a legs and thighs out front, but this right now is a private party, so go ahead and go home now. Sorry about that. Sorry for the interruption. Alright, I'm going to take this off now, the steak. Let y'all get a look at it. Can you see it? Oh. Let me get the thing. There you go. Juicy, and let it rest. That's my lunch today. Okay, here's a fajita. Flip it over. Oh, yeah, there you go. Mm-mm. That's going to be good, too. It's all good, right, folks? Flip it over again. This thing's working really good, this Dina Bobber. See that? Flip it again. Keep flipping it. Okay, that's what we got. We got a ribeye here. Cooked, didn't it? We got a fajita. Look at that juice just coming out of there. Yeah, that's awesome. Look at that. Awesome, awesome. So this is about rested. Probably cut into that and eat that, and then I'll save that for later. Alright, I'm going to try to do this without getting in the way. I'm going to hold it with this, actually, and then just cut a little chunk out of here. There we go. Come on, get him. Well, here's what we got. We've got a nice little chunk of meat there. Look inside here. See how it is? It's nice and medium. Well, I like it. And now we, dang, that's good. Now we'll try it out on the camera.
All right. Oh man. Whew. Hot outside. Take my hat off. Anyway, a little piece of steak that I cut off. Go ahead and try it. Oh man. Delicious. All I used was sea salt and fresh cracked pepper. So, trick is Greg showed me how to do it. You got to sear the meat shut with the hot flame. Sear it shut, that holds the juices in. You know, a lot of people don't know that. He talks about it a lot on the radio show, how to do that. So that's what I've been doing, just like he taught me. Anyway, about it for now. Eat the fajitas later. I know they'll be okay. Anyway, God bless you, and we'll see you next time. Bye.